This project settings class is going to cover how to set up a cost code. So let's navigate to the cost code catalog. Set up. Under cost codes, we're going to go to the standard cost code catalog. So the system already has some cost codes set up. So let me scroll down a little bit. So you can see that there is a parent or group, whatever you want to call it, cost code D30 for building. There's a child, D30.10 hard costs. And then there's, I guess you call them grandchildren, under the child for the various hard costs. So there's the blue is then another layer. Okay. So let's just look at one of the cost codes that are already set up. We'll explain the fields so you know how to, and then we'll show you how to add a cost code. Okay, so first step you'll give it an ID. The second step is to give it a name. Okay, so whatever you want to call it there. Description is a little bit longer of a field. You can put some more information in. Production unit description, you could put something in there if you like. If it's each or foot or lump sum or something. Status, probably going to want to put active. Priority is not really used, so you can skip that or put a one in there if you want. Parent ID would be where you want this cost code to fall under. So if there's a parent heading, you want to pick that in that field. So this field here, you would select something if the item you want to associate the item with a cost code. So items are in sales and purchasing. If the cost code is billable, you'll want to pick something here in the item. Billable checkbox here would be if you want to checkmark this to be able to bill the time entries to the customer. Okay, so you want to checkmark that. Milestone is if, for example, on a fixed fee project, if you reach a certain percentage on completion, it's going to let you know that you have reached that milestone. So if you checkmark this here, it will allow you to use milestone tracking, which is set up in another area. Okay. So utilized box would be if you want to indicate progress on a customer project or an internal project even. You do not want to check that when it is a task that it's not really tracking progress on. So if you want your employees to track time, filling out or doing administrative things, you can, you know, uncheck this, and it's more like a non-utilized cost code. So that's what that means there. Time types field here can be utilized if you want some better reporting on clarifying how much of like a project's staff cost is spent on salary, overtime, regular hours, you know, so you can do different time types. You can add different ones here if you want. It's not necessarily required. There are times it is required if you're setting up post labor costs to the GL accounts you specify, then you'll want to set a time type here. WBS code is not something you need to worry about filling in. And then the standard cost types that you'll want for this cost code, that you want to be available for this cost code, you will put down here. So you could put development, materials, you can add however many you want down here. Okay, and then you're gonna hit save. And that is how you add a cost code.